Breaking news on GE. Whoa, David Faber. Thank God we switched the savings day. He's got that extra hour on Saturday. He's up. Joins us now on the Squawk Newsline. David.
Joe, something you and I have probably been expecting for quite some time, although it's been years in the making, and not a particularly uplifting story. But GE this morning, right now actually, announcing its plans to form three public companies. Whoa. It will be splitting up, becoming pure plays in aviation, healthcare, and energy. As I said, this news will be announced at this moment. I did have a chance to talk to Larry Culp, the company's CEO, as well, and can fill you in on what his thoughts were and why now. But what now is GE Aviation, GE Healthcare, and what they're calling the combined GE Renewable Energy, Power, and Digital business, all to be separated. They're going to separate healthcare first in early 2023 through a tax-free spinoff. There is an intention to retain 19.9% of that business, at least initially, at GE. Then they expect in early 24 to spin renewable energy and power. And what will be left of GE is aviation. Larry Culp will run that company, or continue to run aviation, which will also have some of those assorted liabilities that we've gotten to know so well, including, of course, long-term care. But, Joe, perhaps not a surprise, and yet when you hear it, still something of a surprise. The company we long worked for, of course, once one of the largest market cap companies in the world, now will be split into its component parts. Culp telling me this is what customers want. They want the focus. The time is right now because of the deleveraging that's taken place over the last couple of years. He also talked about being in a post-COVID environment, which is encouraging to hear as well. But basically continued to emphasize during a conversation we just had that really it's on the part of customers that they are doing this, because that is the focus that they want from each of these companies.
Well, it's hard to argue with the rationale, David. Makes perfect sense. And the model that we knew so well, where GE Capital sort of funded and was synergistic with all the other manufacturing pieces. And you remember how they had it was a pretty good racket there for a while. And, you know, people would say that, you know, Welch always, the late, great Jack Welch always had a couple of pennies of operating earnings in the drawer to use to beat expectations. When it was the most valuable company, David, wasn't it at about 50 times earnings? It was crazy, whatever was happening when it was worth $600 billion. But it's a little bittersweet, right? Thomas Edison, Dow component, biggest market cap round now, sort of going the way of ITT or Rand Ariscog or all those other de-conglomerizations, whatever you want to call it.
Hey, David, is the GE name going to continue with any of those three?
It is, yeah. The GE name, Becky, is going to continue with aviation. And as I said, Culp will continue to lead aviation. So that will be what is left. John Slattery will be sort of running it day to day, but he will continue, that is Culp, to be chairman and CEO of GE, which will contain aviation. And it's my understanding, and I think it's made fairly clear, that the name, at least as of now, is not going to change. But the other two companies obviously may have a very different future. I'm not certain about what the names are going to be. And obviously, as you know, Becky, as well, some of the key considerations are capital allocation, how much debt you jettison with the respective companies right. that are spun off as right. well.
You know, just watching this, they say it's about customers and what customer wants, but it's probably pretty clearly what shareholders want, too. The stock's now up almost 8% on this.